Now you come to Rama Nath Sharma. He is the one who has done all these nonsensical things way back, beginning with the 1987 with this book. No one else has done this. This is my own notation. T abbreviations. Applying your understanding of Adi Antena Sahita. You go to the first Shiva Sutra, don't begin the abbreviation with A. You are free to choose any. Here in this case, we are selecting E. So you get E, U, Ri. Adir Madhyaga Nam Sarvesham Pratinidhitvam Karoti. So Ar Pratinidhitvam Bhavati. So, ik represents e, u, ri, lri, right? Because a, e, u, ra, ri, lri. So, you take ri, lri from Sri Sutra 2 and e, u from Sri Sutra 1. So, you got ik, yana. Go to ha ya va ra ta. So leave out ha, begin with ya, ya va ra la. So then ach. Take all the ayunarilrik evong ayaucha. That gives you what? Ach. What is the word for vowel in Sanskrit? Ach. That's the origin. That abbreviation, see, he said that I'm going to make the pratyaharas for use, carry out the processes of the grammar. So, ach is an abbreviation. A term, what is the word for consonant? Hal. Ha, ya, ba, ra, ta, la, na, ya, ma, ga, na, ma, ja, ba, ga, da, la, kha, ja, ba, ga, da, la, sa, kha, pa, cha, ta, ta, cha, ta, ta, wa, ka, pa, ya, sa, kha, sa, ra, hal. Great exercise, but. Okay. So you apply Adirantena Sahita and you form zillions of the abbreviations. Then you have to formulate a rule. The idea is let ik be replaced with yana when ach follows. Okay? Let A be replaced with B when C follows. It's a rewrite rule, folks. So I'm going to represent Iko Yarachi as a rewrite rule. See, you say, ika sthane yana syat. Sthane, where do you get the sense of sthane? Sashti sthane yoga. That's the particular meaning of sashti that Pāṇini assigns to. He says that in the Shastra, when there is no particularly fixed meaning of genitive offered, then you should interpret that genitive as anyat yoga sashti. That whose yoga connection is not previously fixed. So, you should understand that in place of. In my Shastra, genitive means in place of. If my genitive is not interpretable otherwise, interpret that as in place of sthane. So, in place of ik. Then, yana. So let yana replace ik. And you know what yana is, yavarala, etc. When achi 7-1. What is genitive? Tasmin niti nirdishte purvasya. that which has been represented in the Saptami. Where do you get the sense of Saptami? Pāṇini talks a great deal in terms of the variables, yada and tad, folks remember. If you want to interpret properly the Pāṇinian rules, you must know this fact that this guy talks more in terms of variables, and those variables are yat, tat. So yat, tat, yasmin, tasmin, right? Then yasmat, tasmat, yasya, tasya, tasya tayoha tesham. So all these variables he uses in the rules. When you go to the rules, oh, there's one thing I don't want to forget. So before I forget that thing, let me just warn you or tell you, encourage you to take the Astadhyayi. And if you don't have the text of the Astadhyayi, ask me, I'll send you that. I have my own listings of all the sutras, etc. So when you go, you are eating. Take that text of the Astadhyayi. Just look at that. First Adhyaya, first Pada. Take a look. Tasmin Niti Nirdeshte Purvase. Do I understand this? What's happening in that sutra? It's a great idea to understand the sutras. So in other words, make use of every minute. Don't waste any time. You are walking, thinking. Hey, the other day I read Yasmat Pratyaya Tadadi Pratyaya Angam. See, Yat, Tat, Tad. Yasmat Pratyaya Tadadi Pratyaya Angam. So, variables. You know how to understand, how to interpret that. And in the first Pada or in the Sangya Prakarana, you will find all these variables and how to assign the value. Like yasya is genitive, singular. Yasya is a variable. See, any genitive singular will give you the sense of sthane in the singular. And that's what is happening here. Let B replace A if C follows. Okay? When C follows, the value of C is ach. And this is the following one, so put it in the genitive. It's a locative. It's a singular, so put 7-1. Yours truly is the one who started using the notation in 1987. So, you have a rewrite rule, and there are tons of rewrite rules. So, let it be replaced with yana when ach follows, eko yana achi. In order to interpret ik, you have to bring the pratyaharas. Then, that will be adhirantena saheta. And another thing, let ik be replaced with yana. So, on these replacements, there are questions. A, E, U, Ri, Lui, 4. Then, E, U, Ri, Lui, 4, be replaced with Yavarala, 4. So, what should be replaced with what? Why can I not replace I with you? So, how do you know? It doesn't mean that, you know, you bring your own idea of, I mean, there are certain generalizations, certain generalities which can prompt you to that, because this is what happens in loka. You are distributing food to some people, you ask them to be in line, so in that order you pay. But Pāṇini is very particular about it. He has a rule. He said, yatha sankhyam anudesha samanam. So you got one rule of pratyahara formation, adhirantena saheta. Then on the replacement, he says, if I give you sets with equal number of elements, their order is determined based on the order they are listed. Okay? So, Adirantena Sahita, then Yatha Sankhyamar Udesha Samanam, etc. And then you get, so E will be replaced with U. U will be replaced with what? V, Va, okay? Ri, Ra, Ri, La. And then as follows, any as follows. So, getting back to Paspashanika. Rules are made to, formulated to apply so that they can give you the better comprehension of words. How is it made possible? Laksha lakshane vyakaranam. You should always use the lakshana sutra in order to arrive at a particular laksha. That is what ishta is known in grammar. Ishta siddhyartham. The desired results you want. So the application of rules is desired. Okay? So, we will come back to this question of how to constrain the rules. Because that forms the, there is one section, how are Ashtadhyayi rules formulated? That is one consideration. Then, how are the rules of the Ashtadhyayi interpreted? Then third, how are the rules of the Ashtadhyayi applied so that they can yield? They could not yield undesired results. They always yield desired results. So there are some safeguards built into the Ashtadhyayi whereby you cannot find undesired results yielded by rule applications. That I will come to. That is called what? Rule interaction. In Sanskrit, they talk about badhya badhaka bhava. There are certain rules, when they see a certain rules, they become kruddha. I don't want to see him, I don't want to see him. So you have to block the application of that one against the application of another one. That is what badhya badhaka bhava chinta is. Okay? There is an article I did. Patanjali, all over the Mahabhashya, that is the third characteristics of the Pāṇinian grammar. Remember, I said, he makes it possible the understanding of the words which are used in usage. What is usage? Usage is loka. So, loka. That I wrote a paper, a big paper, which you can find all the references in this book. I said, looking outside at the world inside, from the world inside. So sometimes Patanjali raises the question. He says, oh, this doesn't happen in loka. Or sometimes he says, not tadvat iha shastre. So what is happening there, that doesn't happen in here, in the shastra. And he takes the lokika nyayas for illustration of fight between two rules, rule interaction. For example, we got the apavada and samanya utsarga. An apavada always blocks the utsarga, period. Want an example? Not with a rule. There are tons of examples in the Ashtadhyayi I can give you. Let's go to the Loka. What happens there? Tadhi brahmane vadhiyatam takram kaundinyaya. Let the brahmanas have the yogurt. Offer takra to Kaundinya. Takra is buttermilk, mattha. So let Kaundinya have mattha, give the tadhi to the brahmanas. What happens when Kaundinya is a brahmana? No. Because there is the injunction. It says that Kaundinya only gets mattha. So if you don't give the mattha to Kaundinya, there is virodha with the shruti, with the command, with the order. So you must give mattha to Kaundinya. Okay? What if we gave dadhi to all the brahmanas and takra to Kaundinya? Then after every brahmana has eaten, can we offer dadhi to Kaundinya? No. Vipratishedhe yad badhitam tad badhitam eva. Once it is blocked forever.